Helene here at the UFC Apex, being joined by one of the fan favorites, the beloved Mr. Cub Swanson. Now, first off, I have to say, those family vlogs you've been posting on your Instagram, I really enjoy watching them.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. That was the plan. You know, I just wanted to, me and my wife wanted to give people a kind of an inside look of a day in the life of a, you know, everyday fighter. We all have different lives and paths, and everyone's different. So with me and my wife and our kind of our family life, just seeing all the crazy stuff that we have to do, you know, changing the diapers and feeding them, bathing them, and then being able to keep up my same regimen of training, it's a lot. And I wanted to give people an inside look of that.
Well, you guys are definitely doing such a great job, and I'm sure pretty soon your sons, they're gonna have a conversation with you in those episodes.
Yeah, they're talking right now, just little by little. But yeah, it'll be real soon, and I think it's cool to see, you know, for the fans to see them growing up and how they develop as well.
Yes, absolutely. Now, looking ahead at tomorrow night, you're fighting Giga, but he's kind of been on your radar since even before his pro MMA debut. I believe you mentioned that in an interview before. What are your expectations for yourself going for tomorrow night?
Well, he was on my radar because my manager wanted to manage him, and he was trying to help him out. He ended up going a different direction, but we've been kind of friendly for years. We've, you know, been around each other in the gym, not really trained or anything, but we've always been friendly. So when he said he was going to knock me out and be violent and all this, I kind of surprised. I think he's just hyping himself up. But yeah, I'm excited for the fight. I think, you know, he's definitely got some talent. And with his skill set versus mine, it makes for a fan-friendly fight.
Absolutely. Now, looking at 2021, what are some goals you have set for yourself? Because you are riding that two-fight win streak.
Well, I'd like to get this win, and I'd like to do it in a very exciting fashion. I'd like to finish him and be able to, you know, start asking for the big fights again. I wanted to take the time and make some changes in my game and, you know, take on the newcomers and build my record back up and say, okay, I'm ready for the big fights and give myself one last, you know, title run.
Well, speaking of big fights, I know you train with a lot of great fighters like Juan Archuleta, TJ Dillashaw, and most recently, I believe not too long ago, someone you fought before, Brian Ortega. He's coaching the Ultimate Fighter. What's it been like kind of training and working with him?
It was cool because we really weren't cool after our fight. That's really because of me. I was, bitter about losing to him and him getting a lot of hype after that, and I thought I was winning the whole fight. And so it really took Juan to convince me that it would be in my best interest to work with him. And, you know, I had to swallow my pride and, you know, made a peace offering and we started training together. And I was able to help him a little bit for his last fight against the Korean Zombie, which he did amazing. And so it was really cool to see that and be able to help with that. And we've been, and I added a good training partner. So all in all, it was a learning experience for me. And, it's been all good.
You made your pro debut July 2004, fought so many greats from Jose Aldo, Frankie Edgar, Max Holloway, to, like you just mentioned, Brian Ortega, Charles Oliveira, Dustin Poirier. And we can't forget that fight of the year against Do Ho Choi back in 2016. When you reflect on your career, what moment are you most proud of?
I get asked that a lot, and it's such a difficult question because there's so many great ones for different reasons. Every fight has a different story behind it, and I could sit here and talk about it forever and tell you this fight I had this injury and I had doubt, or this one I had family issues, or it's just so many things. So it's hard to pick one, but Do Ho Choi is the easy one. It's the one the fans remember. I think I did a great job and it was very exciting. So that's the easy pick.
And lastly, like I mentioned, you fought so many greats. You are a veteran and a fan favorite in this sport. I'd love to get your prediction. Two guys that you have beat. First off, Charles Oliveira. Do you think he beats Michael Chandler?
I hope so. I really like Michael Chandler, and he's, you know, it looks good getting fresh meat in the division. But I think Charles Oliveira, you know, he didn't have a great run at 145, and he's always done well at 155. So I'd like to see him, you know, kind of have this resurgence and maybe make it to, you know, get the title fight or win the title. So to see him make, you know, come full circle, I'd be super proud of him for that.
And Dustin Poirier, his trilogy is going down against Conor McGregor in July. How do you see that one playing out?
Well, I'm rooting for him. You know, Conor is definitely going to make some adjustments and come back, and I'm sure we'll see a different version of him, which is going to be dangerous. But I would really love to see Dustin win again. I love, you know, who he is as a person, with all his charity work and how he carries himself. I'm super proud of that guy too. So to see him doing well is it's inspiring.
But all your fans can't wait to watch you return tomorrow against Giga. What would you like to let all your fans know?
Just keep supporting me. I appreciate it. I want to keep doing this as long as it's fun for me. And I just appreciate all the support all these years.